Right, guys, welcome back to another video, and today I'm going to be doing my WrestleMania 36 predictions. Now, it's going to be a crazy WrestleMania because, obviously, there is no fans, no crowd because of coronavirus, and instead of taking place in a big stadium like they normally do, it's going to be taking place inside the Performance Center. So, yes, hopefully they just do it as best they can. Obviously, they've split it into two nights. One is tonight, Saturday the 4th, and then the rest of the matches are tomorrow night on Sunday. So, getting straight into it. The first match, Aleister Black versus Bobby Lashley. Have got them up on screen here, lads, because there's about 45 matches. No joke. Aleister Black versus Bobby Lashley, yeah. I think it's just going to be a basic match. WWE loves Bobby Lashley, and I think Bobby Lashley's going to win that one. That's all there really is to say about it. It's not going to be anything too special. It's just going to be your basic one-on-one match. Lashley's going to win, and that's that. Next one, though, we've got a bit of a storyline, finally. Otis versus Dolph Ziggler. Now, apparently, I only found this out this morning. This is Dolph Ziggler's first time ever having a singles match at WrestleMania, which is crazy. The man's been in WWE for what feels like forever. He's been there since I started watching it, probably before that. And he's an unbelievable wrestler. You know, he's great at what he does. I don't know how he hasn't been in a singles match at Mania yet. He's facing Otis tonight. Well, could be tonight, could be Sunday night. I guess we'll see. There's no split yet to tell us these matches are on Saturday, these matches are on Sunday. But for the love of this, let Otis win. You know, let Otis win. Let him have Mandy. You know, it'll just be great storyline. You know, it's the end that everybody wants. You know, you give him that good moment at WrestleMania and everybody, I was going to say everybody goes home happy. There's nobody at the arena to go home, but you know, everybody at home goes to bed happy. So I think I'd like to see Otis win that one. So next one, King Corbin versus Elias. Obviously the other week on SmackDown there, Corbin chucked Elias off this big like podium. It looked sick, like, not gonna lie. It was a pretty good stunt from WWE. Corbin's got this one in the bag. WWE loves him. You know, he's King of the Ring for a reason. So King Corbin is definitely walking out of here with the win. So next one. Kabuki Warriors versus Alexa Bliss and Nikki Cross for the Women's Tag Team Championships. Feels like these titles are defended like once per pay-per-view and not seen again until the next pay-per-view. In fact, I can't even remember the last time I seen these belts. Kabuki Warriors have done nothing with it. And to be fair, I didn't see Sasha and Bayley do much with it at the time. But yeah, I guess we might as well move on. So I think Alexa and Nikki can take this one and hopefully do something with the championships. I mean, they're on TV a lot more than the Kabuki Warriors, so they should be able to actually promote the titles. Whether they defend them or not is another thing, but I think Alexa Bliss and Nikki Cross are going to walk out Women's Tag Team Champions. So, next one. Raw Tag Team Championships match, the Street Profits versus Angel Garza and Austin Theory. I have no clue who Angel Garza and Austin Theory are. Why they're fighting for the Raw Tag Team titles, I don't know. Probably the less said about this match, the better. I mean, people barely know who the Street Profits are, and I don't know why they're champions. I mean, what happened to the days of having good, proper tag teams? These guys, I don't know why they're champions, but I think they're going to win. You can't give the belts to two guys that absolutely nobody knows, you know? At least wrestling fans somewhat know who the Street Profits are. They're on TV a bit. Angel Garza and Austin Theory. Don't know who they are. Read their names for the first time this morning. So yeah, Street Profits retaining the titles. Now the next one is a lot better. SmackDown Tag Team Championship ladder match. John Morrison and The Miz defending their titles against The Usos and The New Day. Not gonna lie, I think The Usos are out of this a bit. No chance The Usos are winning this. There's a part of me that thinks New Day could get this again, because New Day just win the titles every year. New Day have been champions for about 6 years, like, yeah. But personally, I'd like to see Morrison and Miz hold the titles for a bit longer. I think the ladder match suits them. That's the way they used to fight back in the day before Morrison retired. So now that he's back, I can see them doing some sick spots in this match. So I'm going to go for Morrison and Miz to retain here. Then we've got Kevin Owens versus Seth Rollins. And this is a match where nobody needs to win, nobody needs to lose. Both guys are, you know, high up in the company. And basically, it's like, just pick one. Just pick one, and whoever loses is not going to damage them. They can come back the next pay-per-view and win, and nobody's going to care. So I'm going to go for Seth Rollins to win this one. Random pick, just have that gut feeling that Rollins is going to walk out victorious. Then we've got the Intercontinental Championship match. Sami Zayn defends his title against Daniel Bryan. Sami Zayn finally doing something in WWE, finally gets a title. I think he is going to retain it tonight. You know, I keep saying tonight, I don't know what night these matches are, but I think he's going to retain. I had a feeling earlier, I thought maybe Daniel Bryan's going to win this, but I've picked Sami Zayn now, and I don't think he's going to win clean by any means, no chance. I think he's going to have Nakamura at least get involved. He's going to have, you know, more friends getting involved, and, you know, they're going to screw Daniel Bryan, but, you know, whether it's clean, whether it's a screw job, Sami Zayn is going to retain the title. Next up, we've got the SmackDown Women's Championship Fatal 5-Way Elimination Match. Bayley versus Sasha Banks versus Naomi versus Lacey Evans versus Tamina. Now, straight up, Tamina and Lacey Evans, out of it. They have no business being in around that title match. They were just put in there to fill it up, I think. Just something Paige kept adding in. Naomi's the only real contender, but I'm going for what seems to happen all the time with these two, and what is probably inevitable, and the only reason she's in the match. I'm going for Sasha Banks to win it. I think she's going to win it. I think whether she pins Bayley or not, I don't know. I think the interesting one, I'm going to go Sasha and Bayley last two. So they're going to be the last two. Everyone else is going to be eliminated. Bailey's going to be expecting Sasha to lie down, hand her the win, you know, be a good friend. And Sasha's going to say, no, I'm in this, I want the title. And Sasha's going to beat her. And they're going to fall out, and they're going to go on another feud for the 47 millionth time. But that's okay, because I like Sasha Banks. So I think Sasha Banks is going to win this one. Next up, the match I am most excited for, likely to be Sunday night, I think. Firefly Funhouse match, John Cena versus The Fiend, Bray Wyatt. Everyone's saying The Fiend has to win this, The Fiend has to win this. You know, Cena beat Bray Wyatt at WrestleMania a few years ago, and that ruined Bray Wyatt's career. It took him so long to reinvent himself, come back as The Fiend, and everybody loves it. And then he won the Universal title as The Fiend and dropped it to Goldberg, and everybody was ripping. And they're saying they're still trying to build him back up from that. And this is true. If John Cena beats The Fiend, Bray Wyatt's career is just over. There's no point in being about the place. There's nothing he can do. He's now been buried twice. And they will have officially ruined The Fiend. That's fair enough. But I'm not going against John. Like, John Cena, this guy's my favourite wrestler of all time. John Cena, I hope he wins this match. I don't care who he has to bury. I want John Cena to walk out of WrestleMania winner. Apparently, this is going to be in some crazy warehouse. You know, what is a Firefly Funhouse match? We don't know. Apparently, it's going to be filmed in a warehouse. Apparently, because there's no crowd, there's going to be some, like, movie pyro or something. Because, you know, obviously, Cena works in film a lot now, so he'll be able to get some of that done. So, yeah, that's going to be an exciting match. I'm really looking forward to it. But I hope and I think Cena's going to walk out with the win. Now, another match where I have no idea what it is. A Boneyard match. It's The Undertaker versus AJ Styles. There's one thing you know in wrestling. You don't bet against The Undertaker at WrestleMania. Because, yes, the streak is over. He's lost once. But it's unbelievable. You don't bet against The Undertaker. And with the way he comes back now every now and again, he's coming back to win. You know, he's not going to show up once a year, lose, and then show up the next year. You know, Styles can probably bounce back from it. So, you know, big name Undertaker. I think Undertaker's walking out with the win. And this one, I'm also excited for, to be fair. There's a lot of good matches on this. Last Man Standing match, Edge versus Randy Orton. What a classic this one is going to be. Edge returns at Royal Rumble. Everybody's buzzing. Next night on Raw, Orton RKO's on. Unbelievable stuff. Edge, I think, is walking out with a win with this one, though. You can't bring him back out of retirement after 9 years and say you're losing at WrestleMania to Randy Orton. No way. Edge getting the win, but going to be an unbelievable match. We've then got the NXT Women's Championship match. Rhea Ripley versus Charlotte Flair. Why Charlotte's fighting for the NXT Women's Championship again, I don't know. Probably because she's not doing anything at the minute on TV. I think she's going to win this. Charlotte's not losing at WrestleMania. No chance. They just want her to be a 16-time champion like her dad, Ric Flair. I mean, I wouldn't even count the NXT Women's Championship, but I mean, I guess it's a title, so if that's what she has to win, then yeah, she's probably going to do it. I can't see her losing at Mania, to be honest. So, Raw Women's Championship now, Becky Lynch versus Shayna Baszler. Becky's had the title for a long time, but personally, I want to see her retain it. I think it's going to be a good match. Baszler's a good fighter, but I want to see Becky Lynch retain that title. I like Becky, and I have no problem with her holding the belt for as long as she wants. So, yeah, Becky Lynch to retain the title. Universal Championship match has been changed. It was originally Goldberg versus Roman Reigns. Roman Reigns had to pull out of WrestleMania because he suffers from leukemia and he can't risk getting coronavirus because his immune system just wouldn't handle it. Apparently he could be gone for as long as 18 months, which is crazy, but Braun Strowman has replaced him. Crazy that Braun wasn't even booked for Mania in the first place, but people still saying, nah, Braun's going to win the title because Goldberg's not back for the long time. For the long term. You know, he's not back to go on a proper Universal title run, and I agree, but I don't think they want Braun to be the one that he drops it to. They're still going to save it for something else. I think this is too impromptu as well. They had the plan for Roman to get it. This isn't a plan. You know, Vince has just decided within about 2 minutes, yeah, sure, we'll throw Braun Strowman win. And I actually reckon Goldberg's going to win this one in about 30 seconds with a spear. Just my thoughts. So I think 30-second match, bell rings, Goldberg spears him, gets the pin, retains the title for an hour. And then what is likely to be the main event on Sunday, I'd say, WWE Championship, Brock Lesnar defending the title against Drew McIntyre. And if there's one thing you've learnt, you don't bet against the beast Brock Lesnar. But I'm going to. Two reasons. One, obviously these matches, WrestleMania's not live this year, unfortunately. They're pre-recording all these matches. Apparently they're recording different endings to all the matches so that the results don't get leaked. But there was an early leak that McIntyre did beat Lesnar. So that's why I'm going for Drew. I think he has won the championship. And also Lesnar, he has no reason to keep it again. And he does this every time. He wins the belt, but he shows up on TV 3-4 times a year. It's stupid. It damages the belt itself. So Drew McIntyre to beat Brock Lesnar and become WWE champion for the first time in his career. You have to feel somewhat bad for him because, you know, he's gonna... It's every wrestler's dream since they're a child to win the title in front of a full sold-out stadium at WrestleMania, and he's winning it in an empty arena. But what can you do? Drew McIntyre to be new WWE champion at WrestleMania. So that's that, lads. Let me know in the comments who you think is going to win all the matches. Of course, this isn't sponsored. Why would it be? I have like no subscribers. Probably about 3 people watching this video. But WrestleMania, as I said, is taking place in the WWE Performance Center in Orlando, Florida this year. Saturday the 4th of April and Sunday the 5th of April. Pre-show will start around 10 p.m. in the UK both nights. And I can see the main show starting in around 12 or 1 a.m. You can watch it on WWE Network or probably BT Sport box office, something in and around that I've heard. I'll be watching on the network. You get a month free if you're a new subscriber. I'm using my free month for WrestleMania, and that is that. You can cancel at any time. It's what I'm going to be doing. Canceling straight after Mania, you know. Paying off and watching WrestleMania for absolutely free. Gotta love it, boys. But thanks for watching. Hope you've enjoyed it. And I'll see you next time, guys. Cheers.